Così si deve lì Africa, ma lo pagami su quando lo hai o i suoi imitando soi e tu. Così si deve lì.
Human Rights Day!
What are human rights? Human rights are the rights that everybody should have simply because they are human. In 1948, the UN declared the Universal Declaration of Human Rights to protect and defend humanity, freedom, justice, and peace. In South Africa, human rights is celebrated on the 21st of March to commemorate the historic events of the Sharpeville and Langa massacre.
Deny people their human rights is to challenge their very humanity.
Despite more and more people getting educated each year, there are still many people being oppressed and underprivileged in some way or another. There are still many people in South Africa who don't enjoy the equality and the many other privileges in South Africa.
Never, never and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of one by another.
Human Rights Day should not only be about the public holiday which it goes by, it should be about remembering the struggle of many people who fought for freedom and equality, for all of us to live in the beautiful country we call home, Inkosi Sikelel' Afrika.
The day is now observed as Human Rights Day in South Africa and is also sometimes referred to as Heroes Day. It was a watershed moment in the country's liberation struggle, hence its inclusion in South Africa's post-apartheid holiday calendar. Let's quickly reflect on what happened on the 21st of March 1960. The story in hindsight is simple. A fledgling liberation organization, the PAC, called on African men to leave their passbooks at home, go to the nearest police station and demand to be arrested for not carrying it on their person. The apartheid pass laws humiliated African men in particular. Every indigenous African male above the age of 16 had to carry the dom pass on his person day and night and produce it on demand for the police. Failure to do so by leaving it at home or not having the right stamp meant arrest and jail. When the police in Sharpeville saw the masses marching towards them, they panicked and opened fire, killing 69 and injuring more than 180 civilians. This day became known as the Sharpeville Massacre. The country went up in flames as anger spread throughout the townships across the country. More were killed in the days after Sharpeville. An outraged international community turned against the Nationalist Party government. The struggle had reached a new level on the long road towards the country's democratic elections on the 27th of April, 1994.